Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which Hive, Scoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. Let us get an overview of Hive language manual. Here I'm googling for Hive language manual. Then you can click on this link, which will take us to a wiki page or conference page, and you should be able to get the documentation with respect to Hive language manual. You can see all the information related to the statements that are supported in Hive. If you want to get understanding about data types, you can click on this. If you want to know more about creating tables, partition tables, bucketed tables, etc., you can go to data definition statements. You will also be able to compute statistics, create indexes, etc., but we don't use these features that often, and hence I might not be focusing on with top priority, but whenever time comes, I will try to emphasize on few of these things. If you want to load data into Hive tables, then we typically use either load or insert. When we use insert, we typically try to query data from other tables and insert into the destination table. We will see those details here. Even though Hive supports ACID operations, it is not very robust or scalable to use ACID operations, and hence we hardly use ACID operations such as update, delete and insert in Hive. When I say ACID operations, it is primarily to insert one record, update the existing data directly or deleting the existing data. It is not that straightforward when it comes to Hive, because Hive is supposed to be a database in big data ecosystem where the files are in HDFS, and manipulating data in files in HDFS is not very straightforward. Then comes data retrieval or queries. We will spend enough time on this topic. We will try to see almost all the features that are relevant to us for day-to-day usage. There are some advanced stuff which we don't need to worry too much about at the beginning. As and when it is required, you can actually go through this manual and you should be able to pick up whatever is required for your requirements. Whenever you have to create the tables or add partitions to the tables or load data into partition tables or insert data by querying the other tables, or even some of the syntax and semantics for queries to fulfill your requirements, you have to fall back onto this language manual. Instead of googling around, it is better to actually get to the language manual and then first try to understand the syntax and semantics of the feature which you want to use and then take it from there. For example, if you want to create a table and if you want to get the syntax of the create table command, you can go to data definition statements. Under DDL statements, you see all the information with respect to create tables. Especially if you scroll down, there is a big box here which contains the complete syntax of create table. So you should understand how to interpret this. Whatever is there in the square brackets is typically optional. Whatever is not in square brackets is mandatory. For example, in this case, while creating the table, you have to at least specify create table, and then you have to give the table name. Again, while giving the table name, specifying the database name is optional. That's why it is in square brackets. If you want to specify the database name, you have to specify the database name and then dot, and then you have to give the table name. Table name is mandatory. That's why it is not in the square brackets. And then when it comes to columns, you have to give at least one column name. You can see that it is in square brackets. However, they specify in circular brackets. So you should be able to specify the column name. And for each and every column name, you have to specify the data type. Optionally, you can specify the comment for each and every column. That's why it is in square brackets here. So you can have as many columns as you want along with the data types. Also, optionally, you can specify comment at table level. Once you specify the column names, if you want to partition the table, then you can use partition by clause. If you want to bucket the table, then you can use cluster by. I don't know much about skewed by, I never used it. But if you want, you can figure it out. If you want to specify row format when it comes to text file format, you should use the row format. And to understand more about row format, you have to look for this. If you scroll down, there is a section called as row format. So after row format, you can continue specifying delimited and then fields terminated by and specify the character using which the data should be delimited when it comes to fields. Same is the case with the lines. So there is something for lines also. You can see here lines terminated by and you can specify the character. And that is how you should be able to tell how the data is structured in case of text file format. And then after row format, there is also stored as, and again there is file format here. To get more information about file format, you can scroll down and you should be able to review the documentation with respect to this. So you just have to start from the beginning, and then based upon your requirements, you have to explore the clauses by referring them at the appropriate location, and then you have to build the create table statement and then execute in Hive to create a table in Hive. So this is how you should be able to interpret the documentation, and you should be very careful and adapt in using this documentation as effectively as possible, not only from the certification perspective, but also while solving the problems as part of your projects.